you're familiar about connecting people who are not connected, which at some time or other includes each of us. And this is part of the allnet project, and we tried and highlighted some words or phrases, because this is my first time doing this. Ad hoc networking is a fairly old idea, but computer science standards. My phone talks to your phone, talks to his phone, talks to Kevin's phone, and the message is delivered. But by now, each of us has a two-way radio. We may not think of it that way. And generally, we use it by paying somebody to carry our messages. And this is an extremely successful model. I'm not knocking it. It works most of the time. That's why we use it. But sometimes, it would be good to have an alternative. And that's what I'm talking about. Now, the major difficulty with this, the reason we don't already all use it, is we all have to participate in order for this to work. And we all know about the network effect being in this room. And we're all incentivized to do less and use more. The benefit of this is we make the decisions about what they should do. And of course, we always have our devices with us whenever possible. So that's it. Great advantage, especially when unpredictable things happen. If you are living in Puerto Rico, you probably know what I'm talking about. If you're stuck in a snowstorm on the East Coast and for some reason cell phone service goes down, you definitely would appreciate this. There's different variants of ad hoc communication. The most extreme is where the message is stored on my device and I walk to somewhere else or drive or make a plane and then the message is delivered. To make this work in real life, you could use Wi-Fi ad hoc mode. This is only available on most devices if we route them, which most of us are not willing to do. We could use Bluetooth, that's available. It of course needs to work even better when we are on the internet. So all the devices self-organize into a distributed hash table when we are on the internet. If you have an iOS device, please download this app if you're interested. It's called allnet Next Chat. If you're using Android, you'll have to wait a few months. If you're using Linux, it's available. Now, there are many challenges to building the system. We believe we have solutions for most or all of them. For example, there's a challenge with distributed identification. How do I know who you are? I'll get back to that. We have been using this for several years now, me and a small group of people who I know, and it seems to work pretty well. Of course, it's always being improved. And so, you know, it's a research project with practical applications. And I think we're stuck again.
We all do.
Okay. One advantage of being completely distributed is, let's say I want to create a few additional accounts between the same two computers. Well, that's very easy to do. And A knows my name, of course, and I have different machines that I can use. So how do I know who I'm connecting to? That's a very fundamental question. The answer is, as long as you and I share a secret, we can exchange keys. Once you exchange the keys, the secret can be revealed without compromising security. There's a number of things that are part of all that. I encourage you to look at the web page, which will come up in the last slide. But a mobile system designed from scratch can be very different from a system designed using wired network. And for an example of this, let's say I want to have secure acknowledgments, but they're also anonymous. I don't know who sent them. Well, in every message, I include the message ID, which is visible, and an ACK, which is encrypted. The recipient, the intended recipient, decrypts the message and issues the ACK. The ACK hashes to the message ID, so everybody who sees the ACK, once it's been issued, can say, hey, this message has been acknowledged. Again, remove it from caches and things. This only works well if people contribute and participate. Maybe this is future work. We can create games that encourage people to participate and carry other people's messages for free, of course. There's a number of areas of future work. One that's recently been begun is a collaboration with the Civic Disaster Center, who are very interested in connecting people who are unforeseeably disconnected. And again, please go visit the website, allnet.org, allnet.org. And, you know, that's only if you want network.